Commissioner.
Good morning, Senator.
Good afternoon. Listen, you just elaborated on creating a new agency-wide licensing unit, and it certainly should be commended for mentioning streamlining new businesses and the processes. So my question is, can you be more specific on the details of your reorganization plan and how this will better serve the entities that deal with your agency?
Sure. The reorganization that we've already made, Senator, is an attempt to streamline the connection between, in some cases, the general public and the agency itself. In other words, the idea of being able to turn licenses around in a timely manner and streamline the process that we have with licenses. Also, looking at other consolidations with conservation and the process of working within the agency to help make use of the limited resources we have to work with the outside.
I held three agribusiness forums across the state, and that's the one thing, the one common theme that I heard in every area was the regulations, and we need to make it easier for farmers to do business. So I certainly appreciate what you're doing there. You know, I was glad to see that the governor presented his budget and recognized the significant role that agriculture plays. Once again, though, farm viability was cut back to 400,000, a third of what it was funded last year. Can you explain the reasoning behind reducing the funding by over 821,000 for farm viability?
Yes. In other words, we were focused on the reapprops for the farm viability program, and we rolled back to the $400,000 level from the prior year. Not last year, but the prior year to last year. And we felt that with limited dollars in the budget, we were able to support farm viability, the current programs that they have out there for research with the reapprops. And actually, the reapprops were, in talking with farm viability, probably more important than new money coming in. However, we were able to come up with an additional $400,000 of new money.
So can you clarify, you're saying that farm viability told you they could do what they needed to do on 400,000?
No, I think the concern that I was hearing from farm viability was that the reapprops, projects that are already started and already on the books, were really a high priority for them. And not that new money isn't important, certainly it is. But with limited resources, we were able to put up $400,000 of new money in addition to the reappropriated money.
Okay. Farm viability is one of the agencies that the farmers work with that I hear, you know, each and every day how important they are, especially when it comes to research. So, you know, I think it's very important that we at least maintain them at their current level from last year. And was also happy to see that in the budget, Pro Dairy was funded at the $122,000. I do have some reservations about the governor's proposal to institute the dairy assessment program. Can you give me some details on how that would take place and what the anticipated amount of revenue would be from that?
Sure. The research program that's in the budget is a program that would be initiated primarily by the dairy industry itself. It's not a program that would be foisted on the industry. The industry would petition the agency, petition the commissioner to go forward with it. However, they would have to vote on it and approve it. So it's certainly industry driven, and that's one of the reasons that the industry supports it. At least a lot of the people that I've talked to in the industry and some of the major lobbying groups for the industry. As far as the amount of money that it would generate, again, it depends on whether it's put together on a formula or on a penny per hundredweight, and ballpark, it would generate somewhere, it's estimated between 1.2 and 1.4 million.
Is it your belief that Pro Dairy then should be funded through the dairy assessment? Or are you saying that it should actually still be included in the budget?
Well, at this point, Pro Dairy is certainly in the budget, and I support Pro Dairy today much as I have in the past. But with the additional new revenues, if the research market order should come to pass, that would enhance any state revenues that are put forward.
So I guess just a follow-up. This year, once again, I was happy to see that the $822,000 was included. But if the market order should go forward, would that be leading the way for that $822,000 not to be included in the actual line item next year and be solely funded through the market order?
Again, Senator, I'm not sure. It depends on the research and the demands that the industry, you know, the new board would put forward. However, I would point out that it would take probably at least a year to establish a market order to generate any funding at all.
And just a final question, can you elaborate on what the state's doing now to ensure that the farmers hit by the latest disaster will be ready for the next growing season?
I'm sorry, Senator.
Can you tell me what your agency is doing to help make sure that the farmers who were hit by the disaster are able to farm in this next season?
Sure. We're working through the ACRF fund to make sure that there is funding available. As of yesterday, the last component of that fund was put forward. But we've been working with farmers right from the very beginning to recover from you know, the devastation that was laid on them by the storms, and we'll continue to do so. We had roughly 350 farms impacted initially with the first round of funding, and we were able to help them. I believe there are only a small handful of those farms that haven't expended some of those first funds already.
Do you just, as a follow-up, do you know how much of the funds remain unallocated from the actual Agriculture and Community Recovery Fund from September?
That would be minimal, but I can get you that number.
Okay. Thank you, Commissioner.